May I have a word?
Are you having fun?
You enjoying yourself in this viper's den?
Well, the vodka is quite tolerable. I'm observing my own brother taking out his anger on ordinary mortals.
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm going.
Szulski, don't play with me.
I saw one of your posters. You look different in it.
Really? The illustration doesn't reflect reality.
How should I take that? No one warned me that I should get in costume for the party.
Ugh, I beg your pardon.
I'm just noting that you stand out among these boring guests.
Impudent.
Just a bit uncouth, I'd say. Do you know the hostess well?
Will you leave me alone if I say I don't?
No.
Svetlana Petrovna invited me, and I am doing my best to meet her expectations. Let's keep out of one another's way.
Whose soul are you summoning tonight, dear madame?
I only know which one I'd prefer to banish. Shoo.
Maybe my dead father's. If you manage that, it would spare me a lot of trouble.
Now we'll never know.
I'll disappear. For now.
Sometimes it's good to let things go and leave other people in peace. For your own benefit.
I think I'll take up this gauntlet. Is this seat free?
The energy is dissipating. Ladies and gentlemen, I am losing contact with these souls.
Well, it was the souls that chose me after all.
It's true. The gentleman has a card.
Let us lay our hands on the table. Let us allow our minds to liberate themselves from our bodies toward the edges of the world as you know it.
Are you thinking of someone exceptional whom you wish to summon?
That's exactly the sort of person I had in mind.
Oh, is it a long-lost love?
Rather a future delightful acquaintance.
Leave her alone.
Sergei, this has nothing to do with you.
Dear guests, I implore you, the souls!
Is that jealousy I hear?
Stand here, right now!
I accept the challenge, right now!
Focus on someone you want to make contact with.
There is one soul I'd like to summon.
Whom do you mean?
Teofil Szulski. Does that name mean anything to you? The poor man drowned on the way to Africa, didn't he?
No, it wasn't like that. I didn't know he would be killed.
Are you planning a similar fate for Sergei? Anything to stir up a scandal, huh?
Yes, that's why. Because only then you will all see me. The only time anyone shows an interest in me is when something happens around me. Is it such a sin to want to be loved?
The powers you and your kind have are terrifying!
That's why people hate you! That's why my father is cracking down on you!
All that matters is I have what I wanted.
Don't you dare! You were supposed to stay away. I was supposed to leave here with Velis. All that work for nothing.
Tell me, what don't I understand?
Do you know who she is? Who her father is? You're right. Sophia Skawan was meant to have her flaw removed, discreetly. But I suppose it's too late for that, isn't it?
Someone hired you to remove the flaw from Sophia. Who?
Take a guess. Anyway, it doesn't matter now. It's also too late to stay silent. What's done can't be undone. Sophia Skawan is now the center of the scandal. I hope we don't all come to regret it.
Thank you.
Rasputin sees you, then you'll stop fighting me.
Ladies and gentlemen, as you can see, this evening the souls were particularly restless. Miss Sofia, is everything all right? And you, sir, what can you tell us?
I have to explain myself. It was me who provoked the whole situation. Sofia didn't have anything to do with it.
But what was all this for?
What's going on here? The guests are complaining, and with good cause, I see. We're terminating this disaster.
One moment. First, Mr. Szulski will explain himself.
For my own, freely chosen reasons. I was looking for something here, and I found it. I regret that it was at someone else's expense.
Enough wistful chatter. Will the gentleman with a book be leaving peacefully, or should we show him out?
No need. I can make it to the door. Madame, honored guests.
Wiktor, don't scare me like that!
Mr. Szulski, are you all right?
I think it's time for us to go.
I'll snug us a carriage.
You'll have a hard time at this hour. I'll drop you off.
See, you can always count on Mr. Konieczkin.
Wiktor! Thank you. That's very polite. Thank you for an interesting evening.
I'm sorry it all turned out like this.
Not tonight, please.
Konieczkin is up to something.
Wiktor, if not for him, he really helped us tonight. I don't want to talk about it tonight. Good night.
Where's Grażyna when I need her? Hello?
Hello? Hello? Wiktor?
Speaking.
Wiktor, Uncle Sasha here. How are you? Have you visited your old stomping ground yet?
Yes, I'm fine, thank you. And how are you, Uncle?
I need your help, boy. It's a very delicate matter. Are you able to find a moment for your uncle?
All right, so where should we meet?
Remember where I took you kids for donuts?
I do.
Let's meet there. Maybe we can reminisce about the old days. Better days. See you then, Wiktor. Thank you.
get a stake for when your life is at stake. Make any vampire quickly retire. An aspen stake for you, sir? Premium wood, carved at midnight on the solstice. They're cheap.
The steaks are exquisite, I must admit. What else do you sell?
Holy icons, miraculous Marys, salt.
Table salt?
Consecrated, but the steaks, I tell you, sir. Ever since they buried the magician, they've been selling like hotcakes. Anyone with some sense buys them.
Do you believe in all of this?
I believe in money. And if people are willing to buy a stick out of fear, then who am I to argue?
This buried magician, is it Szulski?
I think so. It makes no difference to me what his name was.
For him, stakes are not enough. We need to call the Pope.
Don't tell anyone or I'll lose my livelihood.
Vampires? I don't think so.
What do you mean? The dead rising at the cemetery? They must be vampires.
Vampires are salutors attracted by blood and sizzling passion. There's nothing interesting for them among the dead.
It's what people believe that matters.
Goodbye. I hope the vampires don't take revenge on you.
They have no interest in me. I'm anemic. Please, tell your friends. On Wednesdays, I sell 4 steaks for the price of 2.
Hello.
Indeed. Fanciable.
Up close. I would even say a solid 8, wouldn't you?
I don't know. We'll see when he turns around. Eight it is.
Will you show us something more?
May I ask what you ladies are doing?
What everyone does. We're evaluating.
A solid 8?
You know, on a scale from 1 to 10. You look quite spiffy, sir.
Why are you schmoozing with some sucker who's already suited and booted for his own funeral? And you, lousy fop, got an itch in looking for some philandering at the Marble Orchard, are you?
6. 5.
0. There's nothing here for you. Mr. 8 got some you-know-what, so he caught our eye. And vice versa, I can tell.
Get ready for some shellacking, lads. We got a dandy looking for some extra ventilation. And, as luck would have it, not too far from the orchard, either.
Sir, you have the unique opportunity of becoming a 10.
Mr. Shitski.
Is Rasputin here?
Sadly, yes.
It's good to see you.
Unless I'm mistaken, and you've come with something unpleasant.
Why was she looking at me so oddly? What did you tell her about me?
She's never seen a Thaumaturge before. I only mentioned to her how we met. Can I help you at all?
Actually, I don't feel great.
Let's see what you've brought with you this time. Close your eyes and focus on my words. Concentrate on my voice. Relax and focus within yourself. Follow my voice inside yourself.
Do you see him? He's remarkable.
I can't tame him.
You can, and you will. Look, he's afraid of you. Calm your heartbeat. It will scare him off. Calm yourself.
You look better. You slept a long time.
Yes, it feels that way. What year is it?
Still 1905. Yet time flows on inexorably.
You look like you've made yourself at home. Are you going to be staying on here for long?
No, I'm afraid not. They're kind people, but I've experienced another vision. Though not fully terrifying, it is troubling.
Will you tell me about it?
Later. What brings you to me?
No, I won't bother you. We can talk next time.
The Narodzinski door is always open to you.
The things people come up with. I haven't been here in a while. What do you want to tell me, friend?
I'll be first. You'll see.
Slow down. You'll get your clothes all dirty.
That kid, it's me. My mother thought I'd lost my mind. So did Liga, I guess. And that, as we know, didn't happen until much later. I didn't remember that Maurizio was there too. He must have been. After all, he'd laughed at me later for wetting my pants. It was my birthday. Was it then that you chose me?